Welcome to Yzer's Guide to Bristol. It's not really a guide to Bristol because I didn't really do a guide to Bristol. I just kind of filmed my favourite place in Bristol and said where I was in Bristol. But welcome to Yzer's Guide to Bristol. Castle Park, smoke point one. Well, this is Castle Park. They use this as a smoke point because it's just nice to look at. Got nice areas to go and sit. Sometimes it's quiet, sometimes it isn't. Just depends what sort of time it is and what sort of day it is. Today is not too bad, a bit of traffic, but that's what I can't handle. So yeah, Castle Park. We're going on a boat ride now. I never tried the ferries in Bristol before, so we're going to try it out now. Yeah, well, where are we going on the boat? Where are we going?
We're going to Hot Wells and then back to the Bristol city centre round trip.
We have life rings on the roof, fire extinguishers, first aid, don't jump in the river, don't climb on the roof. if you need anything, I'll be up the back, alright?
Did you get many people climbing on the boat in that?
Yeah, when they're drunk.
No, really? What's good, guys? Out on the boat now. Going through Bristol, we're going to do a round trip to Hot Wells and then back. Just wanted to try this out. I've never actually been on this boat before. I see it all the time in Bristol, but I never get a chance to ride it, so here we are. That's Great Britain now. Thanks, buddy.
No worries.
Thanks very much. That was a lot of fun. But now, some dinner. Okay, we're about to go into the centre. This is all your shopping, your street vendors, your buskers, your whatever.
This is where you'll find all. This is Bristol City Centre.
Thank you. at St. Nicholas Market. This is where you can get some really good street food. I was meant to try something different, but I might just go and get the pasta bolognese again, because that was banging. And nothing else has really taken my fancy. The pasta place was closed. What am I going to do now?
It took so long to decide that the food market's closed now.
I'm such a dick. Interesting fact, the building here was bombed during 1940 and 1944, and it's still standing. These are the remnants of it. Pretty cool, man. I was going to do a piece on the Colston Hall situation today, but I think I'm going to save that for a separate project. I'm going to get what other people think of it and then talk to them, so I don't want to come across uneducated and like, because I don't know the full story. But yeah, basically Colston Hall's having its name changed, and what I do know about it is that the reason the name's really been changed is because O2 and other brands such as Pepsi or whatever are coming looking for more arenas to set up things in, which isn't so bad for business. But at the same time, Colston Hall is a piece of our heritage. It's bad that, you know, it came from slavery and you know, those sort of times, but at the same time, it made Bristol, and Bristol's been built on it. So if you're really that unhappy about it having that name, you need to move out of Bristol for good. I personally think that the people behind the movement, so the Cameron Colston Hall, I personally think they've had some sort of incentive if they push it as protesters and help them get the name changed through getting public cry and public opinion, that they're gonna profit from it. And there's certain members in there that belong to certain parties within Bristol, which are councillors, which concerns me that their corruption has made its way into the urban community, because that's where these councillors come from. It's concerning, isn't it? In other news, Bristol has a Metro Mayor. A Conservative, a Tory, from some bald-headed guy. I didn't take time to find out what his name was, but basically what I did learn is that 29.6% of Bristol came out and voted. That's terrible.
Seagull.
Location on point. Cypher, what have you made?
Squani.
All good, man. Why is TV featuring Cypher today?
We're getting kicked out of the daily.
Getting kicked out of a church, you know? No sanctuary blood.
Live at Cypher's video shoot. Anonymous Media UK on the camera.
Scenes at AmUK's video shoot with Cypher. Obviously did my little walk around Bristol, went on the ferry today, had some Greggs, and yeah, had some of that good, you know what I'm saying? It's been a wicked day, I've really enjoyed myself. I hope the footage does it justice, because I'm not sure I filmed as much as I should have done, or could have done, but fuck it.